Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to BK42 Cycles. I've been receiving a lot of questions about the ZIPFORCE and today I decided to take it out and give it a real bad time. I'm going to ride on dirt, I will try to find some wet floors, sand and all different possible situations I can find. If I find mud, I'm going to get dirty. So let's stop talking and let's get it started. I mounted the ZIPFORCE Distance on the front wheel for easier filming, though it works just as well on the rear wheel. While riding over stones and rocks, the grip remained solid, with no noticeable difference. It's time to challenge the ZIPFORCE even further by riding on sand. It performed better than I had expected, which surprised me. The main issue was keeping the bike upright on the sand, but even then the grip loss was minimal and quickly recovered. Overall, the ZIPFORCE handled exceptionally well on rocks, dirt and sand. The difference between going uphill with the ZIPFORCE off and on is brutal, even on dirt. Now that the bike's all dirty, it's time to wash it and take it for a spin in the wet.
Let's get wet. Yeah, I think it's having some small problem in the wet. I can feel that it's quite slippery now. Yeah, I can hear that. Yeah, something is going on. We're gonna see in the camera later, but yeah, I feel it's not pushing really well anymore. But anyway, it is still pushing, a bit less.
Okay, it loses some grip, but it recovers quickly once the wheel isn't completely soaked. So in light rain, the ZIPFORCE will perform okay. However, in heavy, prolonged rain, it might lose power and efficiency. Another point I want to discuss is the noise level. Using the ZIPFORCE with seat or slip tires reduces a lot the noise. However, with cross or off-road tires, the noise level is noticeably higher, as you can hear. In this video, I'm using the ZIPFORCE Distance All-in-One e-bike conversion kit. It features a 250-watt motor, a 16 ampere hours battery, and a controller, all integrated into this compact box. You can easily install it at home in under 30 minutes with just a few tools. The ZIPFORCE connects wirelessly with the pedal sensor and can be controlled via Bluetooth connection on your phone. Plus, it works perfectly fine without needing your phone connected. Alright folks, I hope this test helped clean up the questions that came up in the first video. Now, I wanna hear what you think about the ZIPFORCE in the comments below. Thanks!